Hello friends, welcome to Miya's Spice World. Today's video is everyone's favorite, which is about new fridge organization. I'm going to share with you some simple steps that have helped me put an organization system to my fridge that works, and I hope that you will find some of these useful too. If you're new to our channel, please do subscribe and also hit the bell button for latest notification. Now let's get to the video. This fridge is reasonably big and spacious for us. This is a LG fridge with 687 liters capacity and comes with 10 years warranty. It's around 2 years since we have started using this fridge. The performance of this fridge has been very good and we are totally satisfied with it. This is a frost-free side-by-side refrigerator. Right side is full refrigerator and the other side is a freezer. With organization, things are easy to access, efficient and beautiful. Now let's see how I have organized each section. Let's start with the refrigerator section. In the topmost shelf, I usually store boiled milk. Never store milk inside the side door as these are the warmest spots in your refrigerator. Since milk is liable to spoil, it should go inside the shelf where the temperature is consistent. Here in our house, we use two different types of milk, cow milk for drinking and buffalo milk for making tea or coffee. On the right, I use ceramic jar containers to store curd. If you notice, I have these small boxes where I keep peeled and cleaned garlic and green chilies. Since peeling garlic, shallots and ginger is little time consuming, this would help in faster cooking. I usually store them for maximum 2 to 3 days only. In this small container, I keep ginger garlic paste. This again is stored for 3 to 4 days only. Once done, I clean and dry the box and refill with the fresh batch. I also keep the tamarind extract ready for making sambar or rasam. I have stored mushrooms in a breathable container which would retain the moisture and freshness. Second shelf is designated to store leftover food and some more meal prep. Like, here I have kept all these greens in clear containers such as coriander and curry leaves. Cut the stems of the greens and place them in a paper napkin to store. Paper napkin would absorb all the excess moisture for them and keep the greens fresh for long. In this box, I have kept some peeled pomegranate, which makes it easy for packing kids' school snack box the next day. In this airtight glass container, I have stored some homemade sprouts for salad. For meal prep, I have kept some cut veggies. I usually don't keep cut veggies in the fridge, but this is how you can arrange and store cut veggies if you do meal prep, especially if you have a busy work schedule. Here on the left, some leftover food is kept in these microwavable safe glass containers. I have used silicone lid cover to cover them. You can also use a cling wrap to cover them. Now moving on to the third shelf. I have kept half cut lemon here and the other half in the door to remove any bad odor. Alternatively, you can keep an open glass jar filled with baking soda in the corner of the shelf. Usually, I store idli dosa batter here. Idli and dosa are our main breakfast, especially during the weekdays. So, I prefer to grind and store them in large quantity. If you have observed, I have placed shelf liners which help me keep the fridge clean and stain-free all the time. Avoid using placemats as either the back of the shelf or the front edges get dirty, calling for deep cleaning. Moving on to the final shelf, here I have kept eggs. Like milk, eggs too shouldn't be kept in the egg compartment of your door. It should go in the middle shelf, which enjoys consistent temperature. This box can store up to 24 eggs. I also store my baking stuff here in a closed transparent box for easy access. There is a big packet of breadcrumbs. I have stored as it is and secured it with a reusable clip. Now, at the bottom, there are two drawers to store veggies and fruits. The top drawer is used to store veggies and the lower drawer is used to store fruits. It may be tempting to slide some greens from an overflowing veggie drawer to the fruit side, but try to resist the urge. The veggie drawer is calibrated for high humidity produce and the fruit drawer is set for low humidity. Another reason to keep greens and fruits separated is that the ethylene from fruits can result in vegetables spoiling prematurely. Vegetables like cucumber, carrot and capsicum, I store them in cling wrap to keep them fresh for long. I use net bags to keep tomatoes. Since it's reusable, you can wash it and use it again. Vegetables like drumstick, rich coat can be wrapped and stored in newspaper to retain the freshness. I also wrap banana leaves in newspaper to keep them fresh. You can also use reusable foil pouch to store lemon and ginger. Since I stay at home, I usually store vegetables only for 3 to 4 days and prefer to buy them fresh from local nearby shop. Greens like palak, methi, I buy and cook the very same day. The bottom drawer is used to store fruits, which is stored in net or paper bags. Like vegetables, fruits too I store for 2 to 3 days only and prefer to buy as needed. We consume only seasonal fruits for maximum health benefits. Let's look at the door now. The top shelf is mainly for the dairy products such as butter, cheese, fresh cream, cocoa powder, milkmaid and paneer. In the second shelf, I have kept all the seasonings. Also, I have kept coffee powder and jam bottle. I always keep my face gels in the refrigerator. The other half of the lemon is kept here to remove bad odor. Now moving on to the next rack, here I keep all the sauces and condiments like ketchup, pizza sauce, etc. Since we make wraps often, you can always find mustard sauce, mayonnaise and other essentials for making them. Here I always keep some chocolates too. I have kept a basket here to store pouch and tube sauces which are hard to stand. In the last shelf, water bottles, soda and juices are kept. We have kept few bottles of cola too. So that's all about the fridge. Let's move to the freezer section. Here again, I have kept the shelf liners to keep the shelf clean. The top shelf is used to keep ice cream and malai, which I daily collect in this container to make ghee. In the next shelf, I keep all the dry flours which I don't frequently use, such as rice flour, maida and besan. And don't worry, you don't need to thaw them before cooking. These help to keep the flour fresh longer and does not get spoiled fast. I have also stored kasuri methi and semiya in containers. In the third shelf, I store frozen veggies like green peas, corn and grated coconut. During winters when fresh green peas are in season, I peel and store them in airtight plastic bags for the whole year. Moving on to the last shelf, here I keep the marinated fish and meat in airtight containers. I also store occasionally used breakfast items like poha, wheat and idli rava. Next are the drawers. The first drawer is used to store frozen items like sausages, wonton sheets and spring roll sheets. The last drawer is used to store non-veg items like fish and chicken. It is a good practice to place a tray under the meat, so it helps to contain any possible leaks and makes it super easy to clean in case of spillage. Now let's move to the door. The topmost shelf is used to store dry fruits. Dry fruits stay fresh for a longer period when stored in freezer. I have used glass jars to store nuts. The second shelf is used to store wet spice powders, which we frequently use and are stored in glass jars. This helps in retaining their freshness. If you notice, you can see I have labeled them for easy identification. I have also noted the expiry dates and stuck it below the bottle. The next shelf is used to store all non-veg masalas. These are all homemade masala powders. Please do comment if you want the recipe of these masalas. In the final shelf, I store all occasionally used store-bought masalas and I prefer to store them as it is. I usually buy small packets as I very rarely use them. That's all about the freezer. A well-organized fridge is vital for safe storage to prevent any bacteria infiltrating your food and making you ill. Organizing your fridge properly will help reduce waste, your chances of getting food poisoning, and your weekly shopping bill. Hope these organization tips for refrigerator will help you to keep your edible items fresh and avoid wastage. Do give your feedback after watching this video. This will keep us motivated to bring more such videos. Also like this video and share with your friends. Meet you soon with another interesting video. Until then, keep smiling and stay safe.